Let's do one final example, this time highlighting the role of deferred revenue. SoulCycle sells 1,000 Super Soul passes for $3,500 each in 2013. Half of the ride purchased are used in 2013 and the rest are used in 2014. The instructor compensation required to provide the classes for these rides is $500,000 in each of these 2 years. The corporate tax rate is 35%. What are the free cash flows from selling the Super Soul passes? Assume no costs other than instructor compensation. Note that customers buy and pay for the passes in 2013. Therefore, we should see a larger cash flow in 2013 than in 2014. Let's apply the free cash flow formula again, starting with the net operating profit. Even though SoulCycle sells 1,000 Super Soul passes, only half are used in 2013 and the other half are used in 2014. Accountants record sales when the service is delivered and not when it is paid for. For this reason, sales in each of 2013 and 2014 is 500 times 3,500 or 1.75 million. Compensation for instructor is $500,000 per year. EBIT is therefore 1.25 million. And taxes on EBIT are 35% of that amount or 437,500. The net operating profit is 812,500 in each of these 2 years. Again, NOP alone does not reflect the true cash flows. In this case, the reason is that accountants record sales when the service is delivered and not when the money is received. As before, including changes in net operating working capital will fix the timing of the cash flows. The item of net operating working capital we will have here is deferred revenue, which is an operating liability that records the amount received by the firm for goods or services that it has not yet delivered. In this case, deferred revenue is zero in 2012. In 2013, SoulCycle receives 3.5 million from customers, but only delivers services for 1.75 million. At this point, deferred revenue is 3.5 million minus 1.75 million or 1.75 million. In 2014, SoulCycle customers use the rest of the passes and therefore the deferred revenue at the end of 2014 is zero. The table shows the level of net operating working capital and its change. We compute free cash flows by subtracting the change in net operating working capital from NOP. As you can see in the table, we now get that the cash flow in 2013, when the customers pay for the passes, is much larger than the cash flow in 2014.